If you're brand new to Sketch and you're looking to start off on the right foot with some tips and tricks, you're in the right place. My name's Joseph, and I'm a design advocate here at Sketch. And today I'm going to give you a tour of the user interface, explain the anatomy of a Sketch document, and give you some basic tips on creating, selecting, and editing layers on the canvas. Let's get started. The Sketch user interface can be thought of as breaking down into four or five different major parts. The first of which that we can talk about is the toolbar, which runs across the top of the screen. And the toolbar is already populated with a handy set of defaults, but you can customize it with different buttons to suit your needs. And you can do so by simply right-clicking or control-clicking on the toolbar itself. From here, you can choose Customize Toolbar, or if you're just trying to get acquainted with the buttons that are already there, you can also turn on the icon and text labels, which makes it a whole lot easier to familiarize yourself with the buttons that are already on the toolbar. The next major part of the interface is the layer list on the left-hand side. Let's take a look at a document that already has some content in it. Here you can see that the top of the layers list is occupied by the pages that are in the document, and then down below we can see the artboards and all of the layers that exist on those artboards. At the very top of the layers list, we also have a handy search bar where we can not only type in a search for a particular layer name, but we can also click on the magnifying glass to filter by a particular type of layer. For example, if we only want to see the text layers that are in this document. You can also combine the filtering and the searching together to narrow the results even more. Just remember to clear out that search bar when you're ready to go back to showing all of the layers on the layer list. The next major part of the user interface is the inspector on the right-hand side. The inspector displays all of the properties of the selected layer, which means it's contextual. If I have a text layer selected, it's going to show me text-related properties. If I select a shape layer, it's going to change to show me the properties of a shape layer. The fourth, and arguably most important part, is the canvas, which dominates the whole middle area of the screen. The canvas is where all of our design work takes place. Each page of a document has its own canvas, and it's infinite. Up, down, left, right, you have an unlimited amount of space to lay out your work. If you prefer to work within a fixed frame, that's what artboards are for, but we're going to talk about those more in a moment. The fifth and final major piece of the Sketch interface is the components view. Let's take a look at another document where I've already created a bunch of components. In the components view, you'll find all the symbols, text styles, layer styles, and color variables in your document. But we'll talk more about these in a later video. Now, let's look at the anatomy of an individual Sketch document. When creating a new Sketch document, you're automatically started off with one page. And as mentioned before, a page is an infinitely sprawling canvas. But you can also have as many separate pages within a document as you'd like. To create a new page, at the top of the layer list, there's a plus sign where you can click to create a new page and give it a name. You can also expand or collapse the page list with the arrow right next to the plus sign. I'm just going to click on page one to work there for now. If we wanted to, we could start placing layers directly on the canvas. But if you're designing for a particular screen size, it makes a lot of sense to create an artboard first. They're completely optional, but they're handy for creating fixed frames on the canvas to create your work within. To create a new artboard, we can either go to Insert on the toolbar, or we can press the letter A on the keyboard. Once you've chosen artboard, you can either click and drag on the canvas to draw your own custom size, or you can choose from one of the preset device sizes that shows on the inspector on the right-hand side of the screen. And there we have it. Now we have an artboard where we can start creating layers. We may even want to start with a few blank artboards. For this, rather than creating each artboard one at a time, I'm just going to use the keyboard shortcut Command-D to make a handful of duplicates of this artboard. Once you've got a bit more content on your canvas, you can pan around using the scroll gestures on your mouse or trackpad. If your input device doesn't allow you to scroll in every direction, you can also hold the space bar to switch to the hand tool, then click and drag the canvas to move around. If you're working with a trackpad, you can of course pinch to zoom in or out. But if you're using a mouse, you can instead hold the Command key while scrolling up or down. The View dropdown on the toolbar also has some nifty ways to navigate the canvas, alongside their respective keyboard shortcuts. Two of my favorites are Command-1 to fit all of your active artwork on the canvas into view, and Command-2 to fit your selection into view. If you're anything like me, you'll be using those two keyboard shortcuts a lot. In addition to artboards, we can also insert shapes, text, images, and more. We'll head up to the Insert menu on the toolbar, and from here, we'll start by creating a basic shape. Let's start with a rectangle, and it's probably worth committing to memory at this point the keyboard shortcut for creating a rectangle, which is the letter R. With the rectangle tool selected, you can click and drag to create your first rectangle. To work a little faster, we can also hold Option and drag existing shapes to duplicate them and create new shapes. If you use Option and drag to duplicate a shape at a particular distance, Command-D will not only duplicate the shape, but it will also duplicate the distance. There are a couple of ways to select multiple layers at the same time. One way is to click and drag from a blank part of the canvas or artboard and drag a selection net around the layers that you want to select. Another way to add or remove layers to or from your selection is to hold Shift and click on the layers that you want to add or remove. To group multiple selected layers together, you can click the Group button on the toolbar or use the keyboard shortcut Command-G. Now these layers can be selected and moved around as if they're one layer. When layers begin to overlap with one another, you can also use the toolbar to send layers backward or forward, as well as drag them around on the layers list itself to rearrange them. Another great trick is if you're dragging a selection net around a set of layers, you'll notice that any layer that even touches the edge of the selection net becomes selected. But if you only want to select layers that are fully contained within the selection net, you can hold the Option key on the keyboard. That can save a lot of time when you're selecting a bunch of layers that overlap with background elements. In addition to being able to insert basic shapes, you can also draw your own vector shapes. But if you're anything like me and you're not really great at drawing, you might have a better time inserting basic shapes and then editing them. If you double-click on any shape layer, it'll take you into editing mode, where you can then manipulate the individual anchor points of the shape. You can then press the Escape key on the keyboard when you're ready to leave editing mode. Another great way to create more complex shapes out of basic ones is to use something called Boolean operations. If you select two overlapping shapes, you'll find four buttons across the toolbar that allow you to combine shapes in a variety of different ways. Once we've got some layers composed on the canvas, we can start to style them using the inspector. We'll start by selecting some of these rectangles, for example. And now we can take a look at some of the options we have on the inspector for changing the style of the selected layers. First, let's round the corners just a little bit by dragging the corner radius slider to the right. Now let's do something about the color. By default, every layer has a border around it, but I don't think we need these borders for this design. So I'm going to hit the checkbox to turn off the borders, and if we know that we're not going to want them back, we can also hit the trash can to delete the deselected borders. Now we just have to worry about the fill. I'm thinking that a better fill color here might be white. I'm also going to hold Shift and deselect the search bar here and bring down the opacity of these tags just to differentiate them a bit. At any point, we can also add additional properties back in, like those borders we got rid of, as well as shadows, inner shadows, and even blurs. And again, because the inspector is contextual, if I go ahead and select a text layer, the text options will appear on the inspector. And from here, I can make a couple of quick changes. That's looking much better already. It's amazing how quickly simple shapes, images, and text layers can come together with a little bit of style to form a beautiful UI. That's it for this video, but stay tuned for more great tips and tricks from myself and our other design advocates here at Sketch.